The next topic which we are going to do today is our close-packed structures. Close-packed structures means that how closely can we pack the constituent particles. We assume that the constituent particles are spheres. So, it's known as a close-packing structures in which the constituent particles are placed in such a manner that they are lying closest to each other. The first one is your close packing in one dimension. What do we understand by one dimension? One dimension is that we are just taking a few pearls and we are trying to thread them in one single thread, just in such a manner so that we just get one single row of the constituent particles. Over here, if we are taking any central sphere, we see that there are two spheres which are simultaneously touching the central sphere. This is known as the coordination number. So coordination number is the number of spheres touching the central sphere in a close packed arrangement. So we can see that over here there are two spheres, first sphere and second sphere, which is touching the central sphere. So in one dimension, the coordination number is going to be 2. Then second, what we can do is we can start placing another rows. For example, this was your first row in one dimension. We have placed another row on it and then we have placed another row in it. So we are now doing close packing in two dimensions, just like laying down the balls on a billiard table, on a snooker table, or simply like the balls on a table. So that is the arrangement is going to be in two dimensions. Now when we are doing the close packing in two dimensions, we can align the arrangement horizontally as well as vertically, such that the first layer, which is named as A, is equal to the second layer, is equal to the third layer. So this type of arrangement, that is known as AA kind of arrangement, in which the first layer is similar to the second, is similar to the third. If you are considering any one central sphere, we can see that there are four spheres which are simultaneously touching the central sphere, and this gives it a coordination number of 4. This gives it a coordination number of 4. If we join the center of the four spheres, we get a square. Therefore, this is known as square close packing arrangement. We can see that there are many empty spaces over here. Therefore, we say that it is not a very good method of packing, or the efficiency of packing over here is low, as more empty spaces can be seen. So this is termed as your packing efficiency, and the packing efficiency in this case, that is 52.4% only. Packing efficiency may be defined as percentage of total space occupied by the constituent particles in a closed packed structure. Percentage of total space occupied by the constituent particles in a closed packed structure, that is the packing efficiency. Greater the packing efficiency, more stable is the crystal. So over here your packing efficiency, that is 52.4. So this is not a very efficient method of packing. Then let's go on to a more efficient packing arrangement. Over here, the first layer is similar to what we have done in one dimension. In the second layer, we are trying to fill in the gaps. We are trying to fill in the gaps such that the available space is less and the packing efficiency over here that increases. Again, when we are looking at the arrangement, your first layer is different than the second layer. Then the third layer is similar to the first layer and the fourth layer is similar to the second layer. So this is known as AB kind of packing arrangement. AB kind of packing arrangement, where the first layer is similar to the third, the second layer is similar to the fourth. If you are taking essentials pair over here, we can count the coordination number. So we can see there are 6 pairs which are simultaneously touching the central sphere. Therefore, the coordination number in this case is going to be equal to 6. If we join the centers, we get a regular hexagon. So this is known as your hexagonal close packing. The packing efficiency in this case is more than the square close packing. So we say that the packing efficiency is 60.4%. So this is a better method of packing the constituent particles in two dimensions. After packing it in two dimensions, now what we can do is, for example, this is your first row. We can place another row on it. Then we can place another row on it. Just like we are filling up one box with balls. That is your three dimensions. The three dimensional close packing that arises from two dimensional close packing. So first we are going to consider your square close packing. When we are taking the square close packing, we are just putting one layer and then the second layer exactly on the top of the first layer, the third layer exactly on the top of the second layer, and so on. So we get this kind of an arrangement. You can see over here, this is your close packing in two dimensions, the square which we have over here. Then we are trying to pack another one, the first layer, second layer on the top of it, third layer on the top of it, fourth layer on the top of it. So the arrangement over here, because your first layer is exactly equal to the second, is exactly equal to the third. So the arrangement over here, it is known as AA kind of arrangement. The arrangement is simple cubic. It is known as simple cubic arrangement. The coordination number in this case, that is going to be 8. The coordination number in three dimensions over here, if we are saying, it is going to be 8. Then the second type of arrangement is from hexagonal close packing. Now when we are looking at hexagonal close packing, we need to look at your hexagonal close packing over here in the two dimensions in a little detail, because we get two different arrangements from hexagonal close packing depending upon the type of spaces, the type of empty spaces which are present. So let's go on to the three dimensional close packing from hexagonal close packing. So we are drawing the arrangement once again. This is the first layer. this is the second layer in which we are trying to fill the spaces of your first layer. We are trying to fill the spaces of the first layer. So the first layer is different than the second layer. Then again the third layer, we are going to fill in the gaps of our second layer. Okay, so now what we can see over here, that we have two different type of spaces. Let's mark the spaces, the empty spaces over here as A. Right? First layer, empty space, which is going to be A, again A, A. Then when we are filling up the second layer, let's mark the empty space as B. This is what your empty space over here is. Again, B and B. So we have two types of empty spaces. The empty spaces over here is given one name, which is known as voids. So we have two types of empty spaces. One in the first layer, which is a triangle. Okay? And the second one is an inverted triangle, you can see the B space. Now when you go on to our third layer, this layer over here, again this is A, this is A, and this is A. Similarly, this is going to be B, this is going to be B, this is going to be B, and this is going to be B. Right? Now when we try to put the second layer on this, we can either put the second layer on A or we can put the second layer on voids B. Both the voids cannot be simultaneously covered. So let's cover the voids B over here. So when we are covering the voids B, this we covered void B. This again we have covered your void B. So over here we are covering void B, here we are covering void B, and here also we are covering void B. Now in this case, when we are covering the voids B, let's cover the next one also. Over here, this is your void B. So we are going to cover the void B over here. Over here also we can cover the void B. So we are covering the void B. Now we are getting another kind of voids over here. Let's say, you can see this void. Let's mark this void as C. We are going to mark this void as C. Now, when we are looking at another void, over here, this we have marked as C. There is another void which is formed by two inverted triangles. Let's mark this void as A. The C void, which is covered by four spheres, this is known as a tetrahedral void. Known as a tetrahedral void, and the void which is made up of two triangles, this is which we have marked A, this is known as an octahedral void. So we have two different types of voids, tetrahedral voids, which is formed by which is formed by four spheres, and octahedral void, which is formed by six spheres. Now, when we are going to place the third layer, we either place it on tetrahedral void or we can place it on octahedral void. We cannot place it on both simultaneously. So, let's first cover our tetrahedral voids. Covering the first kind of arrangement which we are going to get over here is covering the tetrahedral voids. When we cover our tetrahedral voids, the arrangement is going to be AB-AB type, in which the first layer is different than the second layer, but it is similar to the third layer. So let's see